Pourquoi une anthropologie de la conservation?
Why conservation anthropology? It is an emerging current anchored in social sciences at the crossroads between two scientific approaches, conservation biology on the one hand and nature anthropology on the other hand. But as we will see, there doesn't seem to be always a convergence between the two scientific approaches, and the conservation anthropology is not just about preserving biodiversity. Preserving biodiversity is one of the major objectives of the sciences of nature. The American professor Michael Sule showed the discipline conservation biology in the 1980s, and Robert Barbeau made it popular in France. In his dictionary on ecology, the item species protection says that it is a crisis discipline for the actual extinction of species, a new synthesis discipline applying principles of ecology, biogeography, population genetics, anthropology, economy, and sociology, applied to the maintenance of biologic diversity on all of the planet. And he says he prefers denomination sciences of conservation or ecology of conservation. Conservation biology is and remains anchored in nature sciences led by biologists and ecologists. Ethnoecology and nature anthropology is interested at the role played by man and the place occupied in nature. How does he interact with nature? What are the knowledges and practices? How do societies live and represent nature? What ethnoecologies underlines is that there is not one nature but several natures, and that there are several modes for the relationship between human and non-human beings, and that some of these modes go beyond the dichotomy nature and culture. The extinction crisis for biodiversity is directly interested by nature sciences, but also social sciences. Therefore, Marie Rouet and Serge Bahuchet, during an international conference in 2007, raised the following question: conserving nature, what role for social sciences? The point of this conference is that it helped emerge large subjects regarding conservation anthropology. The relationship between society and biodiversity, biodiversity as a scientific object, both concrete and theoretical, raises numerous questions. The place occupied by man in his environment. How far does man create biodiversity and landscape mosaics to increase biodiversity? How do societies preserve or set up biodiversity? This relationship raises questions on future actions. How do we conserve? Do we co-manage? Do we look at the steering of evolutionary trajectories of biodiversity? And there are also questions on the social interactions between the local population and the conservation players, and the question of governance and ethics. Other question: what spaces are interested? Do we look at protected spaces, ordinary nature, natural landscapes, entropic landscapes? And also we should wonder about the practices and naturalistic knowledge of local populations, the transmission of this knowledge and the impact of the practices on biodiversity. With the tools and methods of ethnoecology and anthropology, conservation anthropology aims at understanding the complex relationship between biodiversity and cultural diversity, complementarily with the conservation biology. If there is a convergence between the two fields of conservation biology and conservation anthropology, there is no convergence between, or no total convergence between their objectives. If the forces of conservation biology are projected towards action to conserve biodiversity, conservation anthropology has two dimensions in the conservation of nature. The first dimension converges with conservation biology. It answers a society need, preserving the values for their intrinsic value and extrinsic value, what it represents for local populations, natural resources, mythified or thought artifacts, and objects from the living framework. The 8J article in the convention stipulates that we need to be interested by the practices of local and indigenous populations as a possible way to preserve biodiversity. But there is also a divergence between conservation anthropology and conservation biology, due to the fact that conservation anthropology makes nature conservation as an object that has been both thought and acted, a study object, including for those who are interested by nature conservation, those who implemented and promoted scientists and conservation biologists, or local populations alike. Protecting spaces and species will have an impact on local populations, whether the local populations are at the origin of this protection or whether they are not and do not buy into the process of conservation and protection. Conservation anthropology must go beyond the anthropology of protected areas to look at all of the environment. We must study the natural, ordinary and extraordinary nature, nature in primary or virgin spaces. It is a crisis discipline, but it is also a discipline that must go beyond the mere diagnosis made by ecologists to look at all the interaction processes between society and nature. It is both basic knowledge and applied research with the development of a social engineering field of research. This field opened by nature anthropology and ecoecology, ethnoecology opens to other sciences as geography in politics. Therefore, it is a discipline being constructed and finding its place among the sciences of conservation.